Hi, this is Bob from Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. And if you're looking for an online Toughbook community that gives tips, tricks, and support, hit the subscribe and that bell button for all the notifications of our newest upcoming videos. Today, I'll be giving a short walkthrough of the Durabook Z14i, so stay tuned. So thanks for coming back and sticking around to check out my walkthrough of this Durabook Z14i. So if you recall, last week we unboxed it from the delivery box that we received in. This is the box that came in, and I've had a chance to use this Durabook for about a week. I did some web surfing and different things, so I'm going to do a quick walkthrough of what I've learned and what I like about this unit. I think my favorite thing about this unit is the size of the screen. With this 14-inch widescreen, it gives you nice viewability, and it's a touchscreen. And it's quite a nice touchscreen. I didn't have any problems using a touchscreen. The keyboard's a backlit chiclet keyboard. I would say it's brightens similar to the Dell Latitude 5414 or the 5424 ruggedized laptops, and it's certainly brighter than your Panasonic laptops. Another interesting feature of this laptop is the handle. I kind of like the handle because to carry it around, it's nice and flexible and fits in your hand really nice, unlike some of the other models where, like in the Dell, the handle reaches all the way across the front of the laptop. It kind of is awkward. And in the Panasonic, it's just a hunk of metal that you're hanging on to. I like this one because it's very flexible. So let's take a look at some of the ports that came with this unit that we got here. First of all, this thing has 16 gigs of RAM installed from the factory. I could have gotten up to 32 gigs in this unit. It also came with a standard 256 gig SSD. And this particular model has a fingerprint reader right here, so we can easily scan our fingerprint to turn the unit on and off or get into apps and different things like that. The ports that are on here are, you know, obviously behind the port covers. This particular port cover here goes to the battery, and you just slide the lock like that, and there's your battery. And then over here, there's the USB ports. We have an HDMI port. There's the PCMCI Express and PCMCI 2 card slot. So they still are keeping those PCMCI slots in there. And then on the back here, we have, which I found very interesting, came standard with two serial ports. So you get your DB9 serial ports, the RS-232 ports for legacy equipment that you might be using. And also it comes with two RJ45 jacks for your Ethernet. So you get two Ethernet ports right here, and then of course your SVGA port and a display monitor port. So this is the display port that you would need for an external monitor as well. So you have an HDMI out and a display port out, which is really nice. So going forward, over here on this side, we have another door here, and behind here is the DVD multidrive. It pops out. This would also be the slot where you'd put your secondary battery. They sell a secondary battery that can go in there as well. In addition to that, there's your smart card reader in here and your little SD micro cards reader and that sort of thing in there. And this is where the SIM card would go right here. So that's nice. And then this is where your battery is right here. The battery life I didn't have any problems with. I never ran out of battery while I was experimenting with the laptop. Of course, I didn't do anything too serious. I was doing some web surfing, email answering, nothing high end. I opened up Excel, Word, occasionally typed in letters and whatnot. So it wasn't I wasn't a super user, but certainly did the job, and I was very happy with the results of using this laptop. Now, one thing I will note that I thought was really nice was the rubber bumpers that came on the out, on the exterior of the unit. And the rubber bumpers actually are also what keep the laptop off the table. So you get about a quarter inch lift so the bottom doesn't sit around the table. Other laptop models would have little feet that would glue to the bottom of the laptop. What I like about these bumpers, it lifts it up, and those little feet that you glue to the bottom sometimes disappear, wear off, and you end up not having the rubber bumpers as feet anymore. These aren't going anywhere. You're always going to have these. I mean, they are really substantial rubber bumpers. Well, for now, that's all I got for you on this Durabook. Don't forget to check out my unboxing of this unit, which it kind of goes through what came in the box and my first impression. In addition, coming up in the next week or two, I'll be using this laptop even more, and believe it or not, I'm going to tell you what some of my five most common issues will be with this laptop. So stay tuned for that in the coming weeks. But that's all I got for you today. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them below in the comments section. Otherwise, I will see you next week.